This is the FM Gold channel of All India Radio. In a special program, now we bring you a discussion on various aspects of 2+2 dialogue. The participants are Shashi Uban Tripathi, former diplomat, Commodore C. Uday Bhaskar, strategic analyst, and K.V. Prasad, journalist.
The first ever India-US 2+2 dialogue ended today in New Delhi. The significance, of course, was the External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj and Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman had an interaction with the U.S. counterparts Mike Pompeo and Jim Mattis, Defense Secretary. It is the first time, obviously, decision was taken during Prime Minister Narendra Modi's visit to the United States. And after two times, the dialogue got postponed for American consideration because diplomats were busy elsewhere. This finally took off. Ambassador Tripathi, the first and foremost, if we look at it, the whole sweep of this thing is, if you heard the press statements given by all the four members in the delegation who led the talks, it was very positive, an upward kind of decision. And as Secretary of Defense Jim Mattis put it, he said, it's not that we created something, it is we inherited it, and we want to leave it at a time. The trajectory is much higher. Your first comments.
I absolutely agree with you that from all accounts, this has been a highly successful meeting. It was long anticipated, and there was some anxiety in certain quarters in India also what this might portend, you know, especially in view of our purchases from Russia and from Iran. And there was some kind of apprehension that this meeting may be used by the US to pressure India to change its policy options. But I'm so glad that this is not what happened, and both sides seem to have focused on the positive aspects of the relationship with a view to deepening them and taking them forward. Of course, the major takeaway point that comes from this meeting is enhancing defense cooperation. But not just that, it shows that India-US relationship is one of the fastest growing, especially in the areas of defense and security.
Commodore Bhaskar, many other takeaways, of course, the COMCASA agreement, something which was in the works for several time. And will India sign, will it not sign, this kind of speculation over the last few that ended with India now signing COMCASA, which is a tweak for India in particular after the SISMOA was altered. While we come to the basics or little more details later, your initial understanding of the pact?
Well, first of all, since you mentioned COMCASA, I would say that the most significant takeaway to my mind in this particular 2+2 is the fact that India has actually signed or inked this particular COMCASA, which stands for the Communication Compatibility and the Security Arrangement. This is a protocol, and it enables India to access a much higher level of communication and surveillance software and inputs that till now were denied to us because we had not signed this particular protocol. And there was a certain, I would say, anomalous situation. For example, you know, we had acquired certain platforms, say for instance, the Maritime Reconnaissance Aircraft, the P-8 as we call them. Now, this particular aircraft comes with a lot of software on board, which enables it to enhance its anti-submarine detection capability. So we were in a very anomalous situation whereby we had acquired the platform, but because we had not signed this particular security agreement, the communication one, we were not able to exploit or harness the equipment on board to the maximum possibility. So that was a very kind of odd situation. So that has been addressed. So I would still maintain that COMCASA is the most significant takeaway in my mind. But KV, if you allow me, I want to plead guilty also, because I was also amongst those people in India who had expressed a lot of anxiety and concern that this 2+2 might get deflected because of, as Ambassador Tripathi pointed out, the anxiety about Russia, the S-400, Iran, the hydrocarbons, and that we would spend more time on the dissonances or the divergences between India and the United States. But to the credit of the four ministers, and I would even say to the credit of the political leadership, President Trump on the American side and Prime Minister Modi here, the direction was very clear that work on the areas there is potential for taking forward. I think General Mattis, the way he phrased it is very good, that let's enhance the trajectory. We have inherited something and let us take it further. So in that sense, I am very, I would say, satisfied, if I may put it that way, as an analyst, because till yesterday, I was expressing my anxiety and concern. I even went to the extent of saying COMCASA may not be signed. It would only be an AIP, approval in principle. So let me say it up front, mea culpa. I stand corrected. I was wrong.
That's certainly a very positive development. And Comcast was to be signed in 2007 also, it was discussed.
But it was called the SysMOA in those days.
Yes, so it wasn't.
The Pandit ji, baat ye thi ki jab Bharat ko kaha gaya teen foundational agreement kare. Ek to jaha logistics supply agreement LSA, jiske khilaf Bharat tayar nahi tha kyunki uske tehat kafi sari cheez, dusra tha SysMOA. In dono ko Ameriki ne hamari samvedanshil samjhi aur unko change kiya ki Bharat ke aur LSA ban gaya LEMOA jo 2016 pe humne sign kiya. और आज 2018 में SysMOA को कैसा बनाया हमारे लिए. तो ये सब तो एक फाउंडेशनल एग्रीमेंट है जो कि भारत और अमेरिका के बीच जो रक्षा प्रणाली है, रक्षा की जो चीजें हम खरीदो सामान है उनका पूरा, जैसे अमेरिका ने हमें कहा है कि मेजर डिफेंस पार्टनर के तौर पे, उसके तहत काफी व्यापक उसमें है. लेकिन भारत और अमेरिका के संबंध है देखे जाए तो कहते हैं कि स्पेस से लेकर समुद्र तक है 70 से ज्यादा सेक्टर्स हैं जो दोनों के बीच में अलग अलग डायलॉग्स चलती हैं, एग्रीमेंट्स चलती हैं. तो आप उसको किस नजर से देखा जाए?
देखिए, मेरा मानना यह है कि इतने सारे क्षेत्र हैं जहां की हमारा सहयोग है यूएस के साथ, लेकिन सबसे महत्वपूर्ण जो बात है वो ये है कि अब हम इस स्तर पे पहुंचे हैं कि हमें भी और यूएस को भी ये एहसास हुआ है कि हम एक दूसरे के लिए कितने इम्पोर्टेंट हैं. हमारे और यूएस के जो इंटरेस्ट हैं इस समय काफी कन्वर्ज करते हैं, एंड देयर इज ग्रेटर कन्वर्जेंस इन स्पेशली इन द फील्ड्स ऑफ डिफेंस एंड सिक्योरिटी एंड पॉलिटिकल अफेयर्स, इवन इन इकोनॉमिक अफेयर्स. बट ये जो ग्रोइंग कन्वर्जेंस है ये बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है, ये एहसास होना, और इससे कुछ त्रुटियां भी होती हैं तो उनके ऊपर ज्यादा ध्यान नहीं देते या उनको हम एक तरफ कर देते हैं, जैसे कि अभी हमने इस समय किया.
कमांडर साहब, आस्कर द स्टेटमेंट व्हिच वाज इश्यूड एट द एंड ऑफ द फर्स्ट 2+2 मिनिस्टरियल डायलॉग says that recognizing their two countries as strategic partners, major and independent stakeholders in world affairs, the ministers committed to work together on regional and global issues, including bilateral, trilateral and quadrilateral formats. How does it sound?
Well, I think the subtext is very clear that for India and the United States, I would say that the most compatible domain is the maritime domain. And I would like to recall again for the record that India and the United States, the first area or the first domain of engagement in the bilateral level was the naval exercises, the Malabar. They started in the early 90s. So we have almost 25 years, you know, of the Malabar series. And the reference to the quadrilateral, which I think is a very important reference and I'm glad you picked it up, is really pointing to the possibility, the framework, that we could have four countries, if not more, participating in the extended maritime domain, which is now being referred to as the Indo-Pacific. So both sides, I think, are aware at the professional level that there is a certain natural compatibility and complementarity as far as the maritime domain is concerned. And it is in the interest of the United States, I would make the case, to have India as an effective partner in whatever be the larger strategic objective in relation to Asia that the United States wishes to pursue. So this, to my mind, was already reflected not just in 2008 when we completed the nuclear agreement, but I would make the point that this was reflected in June 2005. So the United States had arrived at this strategic determination to partner India 13 years ago. It's a different matter that jo bar bar hum kehte hain ki jo hichak hai wo Bharat ke taraf se tha, kyunki 2005 se leke abhi 2018-13 saal ho gaye sahab, aur hamare desh mein kai karanon ki wajah se hum America ke sath us prakar ka bhagidari sainik kshetra mein शुरुआत हम नहीं करना चाहते थे, तो इसलिए हम आलाप पे ही रुक गए. आज का जो बैठक है, मैं कहूंगा कि इसकी अहमियत इसमें है कि संकेत जो है यह समुद्री तट पे है. तो अगर इन्होंने क्वाड्रिलैटरल का शब्द का प्रयोग किया है तो मुझे लगता है कि इशारा चार देशों की बात है, और शायद ये जो शब्द आपने पकड़ लिया है बीजिंग के अंदर भी लोग इसको बहुत निगरानी से शायद देख रहे होंगे.
त्रिपाठी जी, अगर हम सामरिक दृष्टि से देखें, भारत और अमरीका के बीच काफी तालमेल है, कई सारे मुद्दे हैं, कई सारे, लेकिन जैसे कमांडर उदय भास्कर इशारा कर रहे थे, जो भारतीय सेना और सेना की तीनों अंग हैं उनके साथ एक बारी फैसला हुआ कि पहली बारी तीनों एक भागीदारी होगी, एक जॉइंट एक्सरसाइज होगा जो 2019 में होगा और भारतीय तट पे ही होगा. और अगर एक तरफ क्वाड्रिलेटरल की जो बात करें कि इसके पे भी काफी आगे पीछे लोग करते रहे कि भाई होना चाहिए नहीं होना चाहिए, हम भी थोड़ा सा हिचक जैसे उन्होंने कहा, ये दोनों चीजें होते हुए तो सामरिक दृष्टि से आप इसको कैसे देखेंगे?
देखिए, तालमेल तो है ही है. सेक्रेटरी ऑफ स्टेट माइक पोम्पियो, इन्होंने भी आने से पहले भारत के बारे में जो कहा था वो बहुत अच्छे शब्द कहे थे. उन्होंने कहा था कि भारत का लोकतंत्र, भारत की सेना और भारत की इकोनॉमी, आर्थिक स्थिति जो है वो विश्व भर के लिए एक स्टेबिलिटी का माध्यम है। तो ये तालमेल तो हमारा है ही है। एक जमाने में वाजपेयी जी ने कहा था कि द यूएस एंड इंडिया आर नेचुरल एलाइज, बट एज भास्कर सेड, वी हैव बीन अ लिटिल हेजिटेंट इन द रीसेंट पास्ट बिकॉज डीपनिंग ऑफ रिलेशंस विद द यूएस सीम टू अस टू बी स्लीपिंग विद द टाइगर। यू नेवर नो व्हाट माइट हैपन द नेक्स्ट मोमेंट, बट आई थिंक वी हैव नाउ कम टू द हैप्पी स्टेज वेयर वी बोथ अंडरस्टैंड ईच अदर्स प्रायोरिटीज, वी अंडरस्टैंड आवर नेशनल इंटरेस्ट एंड वी डू अंडरस्टैंड that India will not be pushed beyond a point into changing its policy frameworks which go against its national interests.
Colonel Ajay Bhaskar, as somebody from the Navy, I mean, we also heard Defence Minister make it public that the US has decided to rename its Pacific Command as Indo-Pacific Command, and also it's part of it that there will be towards that in the maritime security domain awareness is something both countries have agreed to work on, and in that there will be a exchange program between the U.S. Naval Forces of Central Command and Indian Navy. Now, how significant is that?
This again, I would say, KV, is very significant, because if you remember, in the past, for many years, I would say many decades, since the early 90s to where we are now, we had a very odd situation where India was the responsibility of two commands, but the Indian Ocean and the maritime domain was divided, wherein you had Hawaii, headquarters of the Pacific Command, looking after most of the maritime issues and dealing with the nations along the Indian Ocean littoral up to literally what you might call as the India-Pakistan border. And if you drew a line from there and came into the Arabian Sea, west of that was being looked after by the Central Command. And the logic in those days was that it will be better for the India-US bilateral if India and Pakistan are not designated with the same command. This was the traditional thinking. But I do recall many times at track 2, track 1.5, this was pointed out, that this is not the most effective arrangement and that the United States should look at the maritime domain in a holistic way. Otherwise, there was a time when three commands were involved. There was Pacific, there was Central, and there was also the Africa Command. And because of terrorism, because of Afghanistan, because of Iraq, they even had the equivalent of their domestic special forces and those commands looking after these areas also involved. So it was becoming very difficult to manage. So point number one, Indo-Pacific is, I think, important in terms of the way the maritime domain is being looked at. And secondly, the fact that India will now have a certain representation and a liaison with the Central Command, particularly in the maritime domain in Bahrain, is also, I think, very significant. What we are now, I think, putting in place is arrangement whereby the professionals will be able to engage and work with each other. Because if you look at the fine print of the agreement, there is reference to maritime domain awareness.
Yes.
That India and the United States will work towards enhancing and having greater cooperation in MDA. Now, maritime domain awareness fits into Prime Minister Modi's advocacy for Sagar. Bar bar jab kehte hain ki security and growth for all in the region, wo aap kis prakar se security ko prapt kar payenge? Uske liye ye maritime domain awareness jo hai, ek bahut hi khas kshamta hai. To yadi hum America ke saath ye bhagidari kar sakte hain, chahe wo Bahrain ho, ya Hawaii ho, ya jahan pe bhi America ki ye nigrani ki kshamta hai, उससे मैं कहूंगा कि पूरे क्षेत्र में आप चाहे पायरेसी की बात करें, टेररिज्म की बात करें, डोमेन अवेयरनेस इज अ स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट. सो आई वुड सी दिस एज एरियाज विच आर कंप्लीटली एपॉलिटिकल. देयर इज नो एंग्जायटी अबाउट चाइना. दिस इज अबाउट द कॉमन गुड. जो बार बार हम कहते हैं कि भाई नेट सिक्योरिटी प्रोवाइडर, whether it is any of these exigencies, I think MDA would be a positive attribute.
A couple of things that also came out जो आज कही गई और अनाउंस भी हुआ, भारत और अमेरिका के दोनों जो आज मंत्री मिले थे, इनके बीच में एक हॉटलाइन स्थापित किया जाएगा. साथ ही साथ ये भी कहा गया है कि जो यूएस का डिफेंस इनोवेशन यूनिट और इंडियन डिफेंस इनोवेशन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के बीच में एक मेमोरेंडम ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग है, ताकि भारत चाहता है कि कई सारी चीजें हैं और मेक इन इंडिया चूंकि भारत का एक फ्लैगशिप प्रोग्राम है, तो भारतीय कंपनियां कैसे वो अमरीकी खासकर जो सामरिक और रक्षा की प्रणाली तैयार करते हैं उनके ग्लोबल सप्लाई चेन सिस्टम में कैसे अपनी भागीदारी करें. If you look at this, the defense component was very heavy and predominant, if I mean, not if necessarily heavy. But there's one important reference to terrorism. And that's something has been flagged many a time and India is very concerned. And I think it finds reference in the sense that welcoming the expansion of bilateral counter-terrorism cooperation, the ministers announced their intent to increase information sharing, efforts on known or suspected terrorists, and to implement UN Security Council Resolution 2396 on returning foreign terrorist fighters. In this, they committed to enhance ongoing cooperation in multilateral fora such as the UN and FATF. And of course, there is a direct reference to Pakistan. The ministers denounced any use of terrorist proxies in the region. And in this context, they called on Pakistan to ensure that the territory under its control is not used to launch terrorist attacks on other countries. And of course, there are many other organizations which they have named, which will be under the radar.
Terrorism today is a topic that affects the whole world. And if you recall, even before the two ministers came here, they made statements on this. And then, in fact, they stopped over in Pakistan before coming to India in order to give a message. Of course, that message has been distorted by our friends across the border, but who said that nothing was said about doing more to counter terrorism. But the fact remains that the U.S. gave its own statement saying that they have asked Pakistan to move ahead on countering terrorism. And they also stopped the aid that they were giving of $300 million, and before that of $500 million, to Pakistan. So the realization has dawned on the U.S., if that was needed, that Pakistan is really playing a double-faced role. They say one thing and they do another. And this is an element of great instability, not only for South Asia, but for the rest of the world, including the U.S. So that is why the emphasis and the highlighting of the aspect of terrorism.
Because they also say on the eve of 10th anniversary of Mumbai, they called on Pakistan to bring to justice expeditiously the perpetrators of Mumbai, Pathankot and Uri and other cross-border terrorist attacks, something which India has been asking for a long
time.
प्रेसिडेंट ट्रंप के जो उनकी जो सिस्टम है उसको देखें और जिस तरह से वो पाकिस्तान के ऊपर वो काफी उनका तीखी प्रक्रिया रहती है तो उसको इससे कैसे जोड़ के देखा जाए.
बार बार अगर हम ट्रंप साहब की बात करते हैं तो धारणा यही बनी है कि वो जब मर्जी ट्वीट कर देते हैं और जिस प्रकार से वो अपना सत्ता चला रहे हैं कि लोग काफी चिंतित हैं. खास मैं कहूंगा कि अमेरिका के जो खास एलाइज हैं, चाहे आप यूरोप की बात करें, फ्रांस, ब्रिटेन, जर्मनी या जापान की बात करें. परंतु ये एक विडंबना है कि अगर हम भारत अमेरिका विपक्षी जो रिश्ता है और जिन मुद्दों को हमने अहमियत दिया है, मैं ये कहूंगा कि एक विश्लेषक के दृष्टिकोण से कि ट्रंप साहब के आने के बाद भारत के लिए जो खास सुरक्षा के मुद्दे हैं उनके ऊपर उनका जो नीति है, उन्होंने जिस प्रकार का पोजिशन बनाया है, वो एक प्रकार से भारत के लिए काफी सकारात्मक रहा है. आपको याद होगा तुरंत व्हाइट हाउस में प्रवेश करने के बाद पाकिस्तान को एक उन्होंने चेतावनी दी कि अगर वो दहशतगर्दी गुटों को समर्थन खत्म नहीं करेंगे तो अमेरिका कुछ ऐसे कदम उठाने के लिए तैयार है जो कि पहले कभी उन्होंने नहीं किया है. केवल बातचीत करते थे दहशतगर्दी के संदर्भ में और खास पाकिस्तान के बारे में. आई वुड से दैट ही हैज एक्चुअली वॉक्ड द टॉक एंड दिस इज समथिंग वी मस्ट गिव ड्यू क्रेडिट टू प्रेसिडेंट डोनाल्ड ट्रंप एज फार एज टेररिज्म इज कंसर्न. एंड आई वुड इवन गो टू द एक्सटेंट केवी ऑफ सेइंग दैट दिस इज वेरी वेरी सेलियंट इवन एज वी स्पीक टुडे, बिकॉज इन अ फ्यू डेज फ्रॉम नाउ वी वुड बी ऑब्जर्विंग द 17th एनिवर्सरी ऑफ 9/11. And we are aware what happened in Afghanistan over the last 24 hours. Meaning that the level of violence and the challenge of terrorism within Afghanistan and the way it is now radiating outside, you know, we now have this cyber domain where terrorism and the ideology that support this are being propagated. This remains a serious challenge. So I think we must acknowledge the positive role played by President Trump and his team. But what happens next we have to see, because so far, as I said, we are moving on a certain path. पर यह देखना है कि अभी पाकिस्तान के तरफ से क्या रिस्पांस, क्या प्रतिक्रिया है और चीन क्या करने वाला है, क्योंकि आपने FATF का जिक्र किया था, फाइनेंशियल एक्शन टास्क फोर्स,
वो तो पाकिस्तान ऑलरेडी उसके दायरे में है.
पर यह देखना है कि मान लीजिए पाकिस्तान अगर IMF के पास नहीं जाएगा, जो भी कारण है, क्या चीन या सऊदी अरेबिया उनको समर्थन देने के लिए तैयार है. यदि हां तो कल एक बैठक होने वाला है जिसमें रूस, तुर्की और ईरान है और वहां पे ये दहशतगर्दी की बातचीत होगी. तो देखना है कि चीन और रूस का क्या भूमिका होगा व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द चैलेंज ऑफ ग्लोबल टेररिज्म.
इनफैक्ट द स्टेटमेंट डज आल्सो टेक साइड द टू साइड्स फर्दर रीअफर्म्ड द कमिटमेंट टू ऑनगोइंग एंड फ्यूचर कोऑपरेशन टू एंश्योर अ स्टेबल साइबर स्पेस एनवायरमेंट एंड टू प्रिवेंट साइबर अटैक्स. पटेल जी, द फैक्ट यहां से आने से पहले पोम्पियो साहब गए पाकिस्तान और चूंकि इंडिया में पहली बार आए और साथ ही साथ अफगानिस्तान अलग हो ऐसा हो ही नहीं सकता क्योंकि अफगानिस्तान और ज्वाइंट स्टेटमेंट में भी इसका जिक्र है. द मिनिस्टर्स रीअफर्म देयर शेयर्ड कमिटमेंट टू अ यूनाइटेड सॉवरेन डेमोक्रेटिक इंक्लूसिव स्टेबल प्रॉस्परस एंड पीसफुल अफगानिस्तान. द टू साइड्स एक्सप्रेस सपोर्ट फॉर एन अफगान लेड अफगान ओन पीस एंड रिकन्सिलेशन प्रोसेस एंड यूएस एक्नॉलेज इंडियाज लॉन्ग स्टैंडिंग एंड ऑनगोइंग कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ इकोनॉमिक असिस्टेंस अफगानिस्तान एंड ऑल्सो वेलकम इंडियाज एनहांस रोल इन अफगानिस्तान डेवलपमेंट एंड स्टेबिलाइजेशन. पूरे विश्व में एक चिंता भी है कि खासकर अगर अमरीकी फौज वहां से कम होती जाएगी तो कैसे होगा. क्योंकि उसका सामरिक दृष्टि से भारत को बड़ा नजर रखते हैं.
द सिचुएशन इन अफगानिस्तान इज क्वाइट फ्लूइड एंड फॉर इंडिया दिस हैज अ ग्रेट इम्पैक्ट. इट्स आर एक्सटेंडेड नेबरहुड. द फैक्ट दैट अमेरिका इज नाउ होल्डिंग टॉक्स एंड एनकरेजिंग इवन द तालिबान टू कम एंड participate in those talks as one of the stakeholders. This raises, I would think, a certain level of concern for us because we know the Taliban as being rabidly anti-Indian. Now, what happens if and when the Americans move out of Afghanistan? If they decide to move their troops out, then what happens? So for India, this is not just a region which impacts us. We are concerned about what is happening in Afghanistan. And that is why you would have seen this reference. Now, where Pakistan comes in, even the leadership of Afghanistan acknowledges the negative role of Pakistan in Afghan affairs. Afghanistan does not have peace. Why? Because of the support that the terrorists get, the Haqqani network or the Taliban get from Pakistan. So they have their nuisance value. Now, how does that all play out? I'm sure this must have been discussed. And the U.S. does appreciate India's developmental role in Afghanistan. In fact, there was a time when they wanted us to send our troops there, if you recall. But we resisted, rightly so. So we have to watch and see now how these developments pan out.
Madhina, you have talked about 9/11, 17 years. If you look at the US and America, it's been 10 years since the civil nuclear agreement has been made. And today, America has been said in the way, and both sides कहते हैं कि जो सिविल न्यूक्लियर कॉपरेशन हुआ था और कोलैबोरेशन, तो उसके तहत न्यूक्लियर पावर कॉपरेशन ऑफ इंडिया और अमेरिकी की जो कंपनी है, छह जो उन्होंने न्यूक्लियर पावर प्लांट लगाए थे. क्योंकि ये एक ऐसा मुद्दा है जो आगे तो बड़ा है लेकिन उतनी तीव्र गति नहीं पकड़ा. प्रेसिडेंट ओबामा आए थे तब भी उन्होंने इसका जिक्र किया. उसके बाद 3 साल हो गए इस चीज को और ये एक महत्वपूर्ण मुद्दा है हमारे दोनों.
ये मुद्दा तो महत्वपूर्ण है सब, जरूर उसमें कोई शक नहीं है. क्योंकि भारत और अमेरिका के बीच में अगर भागीदारी की हमने बात किया है या द्विपक्षीय रिश्तों में कोई परिवर्तन आया है तो ये सिविलियन न्यूक्लियर एग्रीमेंट के तहत ही हुआ है. तो इस बात को हमें स्वीकार करना है दैट इफ द पेज हैज टर्न्ड इट वॉज एनेबल्ड बाय द सिविलियन न्यूक्लियर कोऑपरेशन एग्रीमेंट. बट आई थिंक द रीजन वाई देर इज अ स्लो डाउन, जैसे आपने कहा है कि 2008 से लेकर आज तक 10 साल हो गए हैं पर हमने अमेरिका से एक सामग्री तक अभी तक हमने खरीदा नहीं है, तो उनको कोई फायदा नहीं हुआ है. देर इज नो फिस्कल रिटर्न. बट पार्ट ऑफ द रीजन आई थिंक इज द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ फुकुशिमा. क्योंकि आपको याद होगा कि ये पिछले 10 सालों में पूरे विश्व में जितना भी हमने सिविलियन न्यूक्लियर प्रोजेक्ट या बढ़ोतरी की जो बात हुई है, फुकुशिमा के बाद भी एक प्रकार से ठंडक आ गया है. चीन में भी, भारत में भी और अमेरिका, यूरोप जैसे देशों में.
फ्रांस तो कम कर रहे हैं
और उसमें जर्मनी कह रहा है कि हम खत्म ही कर देंगे, वी विल हैव नो न्यूक्लियर. So I would say that we go slow on the civilian nuclear is partly because of that. But may I add again with your permission, KV, that there is one area where I think India could have a very robust partnership with the United States, and that is on nuclear safety. Because there still are a number of civilian nuclear plants, and today technology is enabling higher safety protocols. This is an area where I believe, even if it has not been mentioned explicitly, that we should be looking at management of the global nuclear civil, I would say, infrastructure, where I think we have the expertise, we need to scale up.
Yeah, I just want to say that another area which was focused on and emphasized in these talks was the so-called Indo-Pacific strategy of the U.S. There's been some speculation about what exactly this means, Indo-Pacific strategy. What does it mean? Is it an architecture? Is it a framework? But at this point, I don't think it is either. It is not a formal architecture or a framework. It is probably an idea, envisages the rise of India economically, politically, defense-wise, and the impact this is likely to have on the rest of Asia, and how the U.S. can then link in with this, tie in with it, to enhance their own national interests.
भारत और अमेरिका के बीच में जो संबंध है वो काफी घनिष्ठ है और कई सारे हैं, लेकिन पिछले हाल फिलहाल में एक मुद्दा है जो कि एक तरह से टेबल पे जब आया है वो भारत के थोड़ा विपरीत जाता है, वो है व्यापार को लेकर. और अमरीकी राष्ट्रपति ट्रम्प चाहते हैं कि जो व्यापार भारत के पक्ष में है वो न्यूट्रलाइज हो जाए, जीरो पे आ जाए, और जो भारत इस वक्त एडवांटेज पोजिशन में है वो कम हो. तो ये बात तो एक ऐसी है कि शायद डिस्कशन तो हुआ है, उस पर ज्यादा खुलासा इस वक्त नहीं हुआ, लेकिन एक जरूर हुआ है कि दोनों साइड्स ने कहा है कि the talks ongoing exchange between the Ministry of Commerce and the Office of the United States Trade Representatives and hope for a mutually acceptable outcomes. क्योंकि व्यापार ऐसा मुद्दा है जिसमें ट्रंप साहब का एक नजरिया है और वो उस पर अग्रसर हैं और भारत को इस वक्त उसमें थोड़ा परेशानियां।
सही बात है, लेकिन एक अंडरस्टैंडिंग हो अगर दोनों मुल्कों में तो ये बातें जो हैं वो रिजॉल्व हो सकती हैं नेगोशिएशन से। अब जैसे आपने कहा ट्रंप के भी बहुत रिजिड आइडियाज हैं इसके ऊपर, केवल भारत के प्रति नहीं, चीन के साथ देखिए क्या हो रहा है और हमारी भी अपनी पोजीशन है। और ट्रंप ने तो ये भी कहा था कि वो इंडिया को WTO में ले जाएंगे,
स्टील और एल्युमिनियम को लेकर झगड़ा चल रहा है।
पर इस डायलॉग में इस चीज के ऊपर बहुत फोकस नहीं दिया गया, बातचीत जरूर हुई होगी और इसलिए उसका रेफरेंस भी है, लेकिन ये जो इशू है इसको दिस हैज नॉट बिकम एन ओवरराइडिंग इशू ओवर व्हाट इज आवर कोर इंटरेस्ट।
Governor Bhaskar, one thing when of course when you talk of India and US is the very strong Indian overseas American connect, almost 3 million people, rather touching to 4 million is some figures say, and many Indian Americans are contesting the American elections and 4 of them are in the House and Representatives and also in Senate. But the fact is the External Affairs Minister mentioned of visas. Of course there is nothing in the statement to say that what kind of approach, but the fact that she flagged it in her press statement, the thing that was mentioned is observing the strong ties of family, education and business and the spirit of entrepreneurship and innovation that unite their people. The ministers highlighted the unmatched people-to-people ties between their countries and recognized the benefits to both nations and the world from these ties, including the free flow of ideas and collaboration in health, space, oceans and other areas of science and technology. कहीं ना कहीं आपने अपनी बात भी रखी है कि जिसको लेके ट्रंप प्रशासन जो कर रहा है H1B वीजा खासकर, और काफी सारी जो कठिनाइयां आ रही हैं लोगों को, तो इसके पर ये एक तरह से ध्यान दिया गया है।
जिस प्रकार से ये वीजा का मुद्दा जो है, जैसे सुषमा जी ने इसको जिस प्रकार से रेखांकित किया है, ये पहले भी उन्होंने कहा, आपको याद होगा जब H1B वीजा के ऊपर ये पाबंदियां डाल रहे थे कि जहां तक भारत के नागरिक हैं जो वहां पे काम के लिए जा रहे हैं खास IT सेक्टर में, कि शायद इसको एक प्रकार से समीक्षा की जरूरत है। एंड आई थिंक दिस इज ऑल्सो एक्सेप्टेड इन द US एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन दैट व्हेन दे लुक एट द इमिग्रेंट्स, यू नो देर आर टू व्यूज, एक तो दहशतगर्दी के साथ जुड़ा हुआ है, दूसरा है जिस प्रकार से अभी आप देखिए उत्तर अफ्रीका के मगरब कोस्ट से जो लोग यूरोप के अंदर जा रहे हैं वहां पे जो कठिनाइयां, चाहे जर्मनी हो या इटली, सो दैट इज वन पिक्चर ऑफ द चैलेंज ऑफ इमिग्रेशन। दूसरा, ट्रंप साहब का अपना एक व्यक्तिगत एक धारणा है कि चाहे साहब मेक्सिको के साथ आप वॉल बना दीजिए so that immigrants cannot enter, so that other immigrants are not taking away jobs from the so-called American worker. So mujhe lagta hai that once the November 6th election is over, within the United States there is growing recognition that the Indian diaspora has been a force for both stability and prosperity, and therefore it is in the larger American interest to encourage. How they will do it, I think, would be shaped by domestic politics within the United States. West Coast of America, California is talking about a completely different protocol because unko zarurat hai Bharat ke jo brain power hai. So this kind of discussions are going on within the United States and we have to see, I think, ke domestic politics finish kaise hoga.
You know, I quite agree with him. The Silicon Valley depends a lot on Indian immigrants, but also the L1 for visa for the spouses dependent. That has been restricted and spouses can no longer work, spouses of Indian professionals. So that, I think, they must
in
have
fact, discussed. I remember in 2007-08 when I was working in the US Congress, Bill Gates had come to the Congress and told that since you're not allowing IT professionals to come to America, I have created jobs in Canada and I've brought the Indians and other talent to Toronto. And he said, it takes me 3 hours from Seattle to Toronto. So he says, you're losing out. This is what he told the American Congress. Of course, having said that, I think the Americans do maintain ki aaj bhi hum log kareeb 65,000 jo agar wo visa issue karte hain, usme adhiktar Bharatiya le jate hain, to unke hisab se. But overall, if you see 2+2 ended in a very positive note, there will be differences, but that will be bridged by, I think, the nimble diplomatic work people like you do.
This dialogue has certainly taken the relationship to a new level.
And I think the political, I would say, those who have been given the responsibility, Prime Minister Modi here and Mr. Donald Trump on the other side, have given a very firm political direction, which is why I think this 2+2 has actually succeeded. And I think that must be acknowledged, which was missing earlier. That, I think, is the most important element, that there is political traction, which even I was suspecting, saying that it may not be there.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
You are listening to a discussion on various aspects of 2+2 dialogue. The participants were Shashi Uban Tripathi, former diplomat, Commodore C. Uday Bhaskar, strategic analyst, and K.V. Prasad, journalist. The program was produced and presented by News Services Division of All India Radio. This program is also available on our website, news@airnic.in. You may email your opinion about this program at airnsdtalks@gmail.com.